Hello everyone, my name is SiC, and welcome back to Factorio, a game that we haven't touched in a long, long time. But it's time again, because, well, I just got the itch again to play a little bit more. And I just want to expand and expand and expand, really. And I took the time, or the liberty at least, to expand on my road system a little bit, so I can get faster from point A to point B. But along the way, I did notice some problems creeping up on me. And one of those problems is that we are no longer producing enough computer chips, the green chips, and we already expanded on that in the last video, I think, but it's still not enough, because look at this. Our green science has grounded completely to a halt. As you can see, there's something should be coming down this road, and that is the green inserters. But the green inserters are also not getting something they need, which is the electronic circuits. And that is because all of the electronic circuits are being offloaded right here by these two conveyor arms. We also have two over there, so we have this entire section that is not being used. And that is just unacceptable. All of the green computer chips are now over here to produce red chips and these purple filter inserters. And also, these guys are not getting what they need to make what we need them to make. Which I think all of this stuff leads towards the production of blue science packs over here. Yeah, we're not producing that either. So what we really need to do is expand upon our green circuitry. So what we need to do here is we will make another underground inserter. And underground conveyor belt. Yeah. And then the same is true over there, except we will go from here up to there. Right, is this connected? No, it's not. That is not good. All right, so we can go all the way up to here. Right, I want to leave some space here so that we can later on put down some more conveyor belts. This is something that I've not done a whole lot in the past, but I really should have because it's always biting me in the ass later on. So, you know, usually I run out of space places to put things, basically. Also, we should really expand upon our plastic bar production because we are not getting anywhere near enough to feed our production line, even though we have plenty of red computer chips at the moment, but eventually that system is going to fail. It is not going to be enough. All right, so we're going to place this one right there, and let's see, how did we set this up? All right, so one space in between every one. Let's just go ahead and keep to that schedule, then we will have a medium electrical pole. Let's see, one will fit right there, one will fit there, and one will fit there. Now we can have some inserters, of course. We only need the one on each side. Let's see, there we go, there we go, there we go. All right, I am going to try to compartmentalize these videos a little bit more because previously I was just playing and playing and just going along with it, you know. But at this point, let's see, how is this being... It's being divided onto two sides of the same belt. Alright, so we could actually kind of do the same thing over here. But for now, that's going to be fine. Let's see, we need to set these things up to produce green circuitry. There we go. Hopefully that's going to be enough, but you can see as well that we are not really having enough of these copper cables. So I'm going to try to fix that as well. I'm going to increase the production of our copper cables. And after that, you're going to see a jump in the video as I walk over to the other side of the factory to try and build a better production of plastic bars. All right, so where are these things being produced? They're being produced over here. These look to be producing just fine. That means that we probably need to expand upon this production with the copper bars or the copper plates being produced over here. So, where do we want to do this? We probably just want to keep expanding over here for a little bit. But then we can't really expand upon this anymore, so that is going to be a problem. Maybe we could produce some stuff over here and then send it over. I think that was probably our best bet right now. So, yeah. Let's see. We're going to have some inserters taking these things out. And then they can go down and under. But we first need to produce some more underground belts as well. There we go. Then we need one space in the middle. And I'm just going to keep this compact, or as compact as possible. We're just going to add, let's see. Maybe one space in the middle there. Like so. And then we can have our medium thing in the middle there. And we can have like one small electrical pole there and one small electrical pole there. And that should provide power to everything. Or actually, maybe this one could be one of those as well. Yes, it could. We don't need to expend too much resources on things that we don't really need them to do. All right, so one inserter over there, and another inserter over there. And then we will have another road or another conveyor belt going along the bottom. Yeah. Let's see, we need one to go down there, and I'm trying to think of how I should go about setting this up. You know, without getting in the way of all of this other stuff, and I suppose these guys could just go underneath. So I'm going to keep expanding this, and then if we want to expand upon this, we're going to have to use underground belts to go past this conveyor belt over there. I think that will work out just fine. Alright, also what we can do is we can go down over here. I think that will be nice. Another underground belt, we will connect it up to this area. And then we will make sure that this stuff is being brought onto two sides of the road. So let's place down a splitter that is going to split back onto the same belt. So we will have a nice, even, man, how do you say it? Division of materials, I suppose. There we go. All right. Copper cables. This should help us out for a little bit, I think. Also, actually, I just remembered I wanted to expand upon something else as well, and that is our production of stone. Because we get some stone, but these last two furnaces are not producing anything. And the stuff that we are producing is being used up straight away to make walls for ourselves so we can expand later on. And we still have quite a ways to go. So we want to expand upon our stone network as well. And I did take the liberty of making some grenades and just blasting out an area of forest over here that we are going to need to expand upon our production of the stone resource. Alright, so maybe get rid of this tree as well for now. And we can actually have two spaces in the middle because the radius, the green radius that you see around the building right now, that is the area in which it will start producing stuff. But along this way, it's probably usually better to, let's see, place it down like this, yeah. Not entirely even, but this way you get the best spacing, but now we only need to use one transport belt and we will have a double-sided production loop over there. And I think that is pretty nice. So, let's see. Probably we will have enough if we just place this stuff down like this. And then we can go up and go out along this way. And then we probably just want to go up along this way as well. So actually we probably want to stay on this side of the electrical poles. So let's run this up. And what I'm going to want to do here is probably take out this one. We're going to take a splitter. We're going to have one belt run straight onto that side. And then we need another underground belt to go underneath and around the other side. Let's see, this way. And this way. Ah, crap. We just ran out of transport belts. All of these stones will be divided equally along both sides of the belt, and they will have a vast improvement of, yeah. It will basically be a really nice addition. We'll be nicely divided, we will have a lot of extra resources coming in. I did make some big electric poles just now, because they can go really far, and that means I have to produce less stuff. So we can place it down like so, and then we can run this way, or this thing. Let's see. That is the limit. All right. I'm going to place that one down right there. Now we can have some smaller ones just expanding upon it. So let's see, this one could actually go all the way over here. Or actually, maybe we should place it one up. Now we can place one there, we can place one there. That is nice and equally divided. And now all of our new stone resources are producing. Right, and I probably want to have a little light here as well, so that we can see what's going on. As well, that reminds me, we should probably try to do the same on this little road that I've built. So, let's see, small electrical poles. Let's see, can we expand upon it in a way that I'd like to? I suppose this will have to do. We will place it down like so, and we will just run these out along the way. Oh, misclick. There we go. And then we can have one light at every other electrical pole, I think. And this way, our road will be nice and lighted up for us as we walk in the darkness at night. Alright, we probably want to have another little light over here. We could use another little light over there. Another light over there. Another light over there as well. Man, I like expanding upon things like this and just making my factory overall more usable for myself. Alright. I was going to put a cut in here as I walked over to the plastic production, but we really don't need to at this point because I'm already here. We kind of just happened to go towards this area naturally. And look at the amount of batteries I'm producing. Holy shit. Alright. So here is our production of plastic. And what we need is petroleum gas and coal. We have more than enough coal, but we probably don't have enough petroleum gas. Yeah, look at this. The gas can, or the storage tank, only has like 2.2 petroleum gas, and it's completely empty. So it's really, it's putting it away as soon as it's getting there, because of course we are also using it to produce sulfur, and then we are using it to produce other stuff as well, I think. Yeah, this one and that one for now, but later on we will have to use more as well. That is of course because we are not even getting enough crude oil at the moment, and we are going to have to fix that as well. The only way for us to do that, however, is to expand, because we've taken up all of the spots over here that we can, I think. Maybe not these three. Maybe we should expand upon those as well. Maybe not, there's another one over there. We do still have two pump jacks. I should make some more. Let's see. We need more steel plates, so I'm going to pick those up later as well. We do have this little area over there, which is useful. I'm trying to think how I'm going to fix this up, because we need to get the oil from up here down there. And I guess we could do it with underground pipes, and we could clear out an area for some storage tanks maybe, and then connect up pipes, and then they can connect up to these pipes over here, and then all of the oil will be collected over there and used up. I think that's probably the best bet for us right now. So let's see, we definitely need some pipe to ground things. And also we need some other stuff. So I'm going to be collecting some materials that we can use later on. Actually, it looks like I made a mistake over here, because none of these resources were actually being put through to the other side. So that is fixed now. Alright. I was wondering, because like I saw... What the hell is happening over here? Why do we have electrical plates or iron plates over here? Oh. That's not good. Where were these supposed to go? I have no idea what's going on here anymore. Actually, did we need iron plates for this as well? Yes, we did. Ah. So that's what's going on. Alright. I guess I made a mistake over here. Let's see. We need to put this back over here. And then we need to make sure that... This is the problem right there. This is what I should not have done. Alright, so... Now that we figured out what our problem is, we should probably try to do something about it. And that, the only thing that I know that I could do about it is actually hoover up all of these resources over here. So maybe let's stand on both sides and hoover up these things for a bit. Man. Alright. Let's stand here for a bit and hoover up these things. There we go. Now we have the iron plates that we need, and now I'm going to have to clean up this entire thing like so. Let's see. This was a problem. Actually, it doesn't take up too much stuff. We have still quite a lot of space left, so that is fine. But now at least we know what the problem is. And actually, we can just add these in manually, and then we get rid of them as well. Alright, looks like production is back on track. This is the way things should be. I just completely lost track of it. It's easy to forget what you were doing and how you set everything up when you come back to Factorio after a long, long time. But now, eventually, you know, the problems become clear and it's pretty easy to fix. So, right, did that get us any iron plates? No, we definitely need a lot more, and we also need some steel production. So let's just rip off some iron plates of this steel belt over here. Because we definitely do need it. And then we also need steel, which is being produced over here, so we're pretty damn close. And with the added stone over here, it's actually not as big of a deal to get. So let's hoover all of this stuff up. And this stuff is going way, 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 way down. And actually, I'm sucking up iron ore as well, which I really don't need. So let's put those in there. All right. And actually, I should probably create some more grenades as well. Just because we can. And we need to clear out another area, which is up to the north over here for the forest. Let's see if I can get there easily. It's very dense though, so it's going to be a little bit troublesome. But if you go around to the side over here, I just passed it by the looks of it. Yeah, it's pretty close. It's supposed to be around this area somewhere. So actually, let's make all the grenades that we can. And I think it's somewhere over in this direction. Let's see. There's one. There's the other. Alright, we need to back off here a little bit. I should probably clear a path entirely. Alright, so we have one over here. Let's place a pump jack down. Now we had another one up here. Let's place that one down as well. And let us see. That's one there. There should be another one over here somewhere. And that's probably not a good cost for a grenade there. There we go. I really don't want to cut into the trees too much, but cutting all of this stuff by hand is just too much of a nuisance. Alright, we have two up here as well. I need another grenade, but we don't have the coal required to do so. Alright. Coal. Coal, coal, coal. Let me run for coal. Ah, meanwhile, some research has finished, and we need to select something else to build. So, what we probably want to do at this point is... I'm not sure. Let's see, poison capsule, slowdown capsule, combat shotgun. The combat shotgun is pretty useful, but advanced oil processing is probably what we want at this point. So we can have basically cracking, or the ability to crack oil from like heavy oil into light oil and light oil into petroleum gas, because we definitely need more of it. So yeah, advanced oil processing it is. All right, and also I've reached this area just in time, so let's suck up some coal. Alright, that way we can make some grenades. Let's make 15 for now. It will be a nice even number, and that way we can also destroy more of the forest that we need to clear access to more of our production spots. Also, we should probably already invest in not an oil refinery. We want to have, where is it? Storage tanks. Yes, that is what I was looking for. And also, we probably need some more big electrical poles as well. So actually, let's cancel these grenades for now, because we need these other things to be produced as well. Alright. Did that clear out that spot that we needed? Not quite, by the looks of it. So let's throw this one down over here. There we go. Throw another one. Yeah. Nice. Alright, now we can have our final pump jack for now to go over here. And we can expand upon this infrastructure later. But for now, Now to see, we need to have some pipes as well. Plenty more actually, so let's make some pipes. And then we need to have storage tanks. Let's see, how does this work out? The main storage for oil is right down there. We probably want to keep in line with that stuff. Or make it sure that we go up along this way. So actually, in between the trees over here would be the ideal spot, I think, for this oil production stuff. So let's make some stuff over here. Let's place these things down. And then also we need to have more pipes. We already have some pipes to ground, so that's not going to be much of an issue. We need to get these hooked up, however. We need to hook these up. We can hook these up. And actually probably just hook it up like this. The problem is that we can't walk through this stuff. You know, that's going to be the hard part here. So, also let's make some more big electrical poles. But at the same time, I don't want to waste too much stuff on underground belts, you know, or underground pipelines. So, let's see, we can have this one like this. We will have a pipe to ground over here, so that we can walk. Actually, we could do the same thing over here, I guess. If I place one down over here like that, we should still be able to walk in the center. Right, yeah, we can pass, that is good. So we place down one thing over there. Then we will have one underground pipe. Connect up like so. Up until here. You can connect up to there. Regular pipe. There we go. These things are all connected up. And actually, just for the looks, let's connect these up as well, just because it looks cool. I like to connect these up as well. There we go. Alright. And then, we need to make sure that this stuff can go all the way down. Unfortunately, it does mean we're going to have to cut some trees. And that's going to take some time. So I'm just going to do this while you... I'm just going to jump ahead, essentially. Alright, so this stuff is all connected up. I'm going to make sure that we will make one more pump jack so that we can hook this thing up as well. Or actually, how much do we have left? Three, after that one is built as well. So, okay. Let's build three more pump jacks. Meanwhile, I'm going to take care of our power problem here. And luckily, we have this stuff nearby. So, we just need to run up through the through the trees over there. Place this stuff, this thing down as far down as we can, which is apparently right there. We can place it down like so. And oh man, these trees are annoying. Alright, we can place this one down like so, and of course we will expand with some smaller, let's see, you can go right there, then that thing is still not hooked up, so we will take care of that as well. There we go, and we can have some lights here as well, just so we can see from far off that we're actually producing something over here. We probably want to have the same thing over there, so actually we don't want that one. We want to have this one. Let's place one thing down over here. Let's have a light. And let's build another light. Ooh. Right there. And now we can see from a distance that this is actually a resource production area. Right, we have our three pump jacks, so let's place this one down as well. And actually, we're going to need some more pipes. And we're going to need some more pipe to ground as well. And let's see. We have one grenade left, but that doesn't really matter because we need two. And these pump jacks are going to take some time. So we probably just need to clear these things out by ourselves. Later on, however, this is still not going to be enough oil. That is going to be a problem for a long, long time. So what we're going to want to do is look for an expansion spot, and I already saw one that is really interesting. Let's see, we have the map. Once I zoom out, you can see we have some more oil right here, and it is pretty safe to expand upon as well. We have a lot of alien bases in the area, but pollution isn't reaching them for now, which is a great thing. Same things over here, like all of these trees, all of these forests are really helping us keep our pollution in check. I should be really grateful for that. Looks like this pollution over here might soon reach this small base and we need to have some defenses ready. But this forest over there is sucking up all the pollution that makes sure that this base is not actually attacking us yet, even though we have defenses set up in case they want to. Yeah. Alright, so we just cleared up this one right there. Let's see, that is the top one. Alright, and looks like advanced oil processing is finished already. Bullet damage could be good. But probably we want to research something else first. Let's see, is there anything interesting? Electrical engine. Yeah, we need it for a lot of different things. So, electrical engine is fine, let's build one of those. And actually, maybe now that we're not producing anything, let's make a few grenades, because this is already annoying the hell out of me. Alright. And of course we are damaging our own thing as well, but we can repair it, no problem. There we go. Alright. So we have another spot of oil right there, and we have another spot of oil right here. And then that means all of this stuff is now officially hooked up. Alright. Then we need an underground pipe as well. Hook that up to this area right there. And then of course, we're going to need power. Let's see, we can have one like so. Another one like so. And then we will build some lights as well. And of course, we want to have this one hooked up as well. And that doesn't quite work out, which is unfortunate. But we can do it like so. All right, do we have? Yes, we do. Alright, excellent. Now we are producing more oil. Of course, these things right now are producing quite a lot. But over time, these will slow down more and more. And that's really annoying and unfortunate, but that means we have a clear need to expand upon our oil production every single time. We will always need more oil. There is never going to be enough. Especially the more stuff that we are producing in the main factory, the more oil that we will need to power it all. And actually, I'm looking forward to version 15 of Factorio, because that version will essentially mean that we get new train cars, and they will be there essentially just for oil. Right now, we have to put all of this stuff in barrels if we want to bring it somewhere by train. But later on, that's not going to be needed. So, when version 15 hits, that's probably what we want to do: is just build a train that takes out all the oil from here to there. And then later on we can have another expansion right there, because you can see there is a shit ton of oil right down to the bottom there. And that is going to be really, really good. But of course we do have to clear out all of these alien bases first, and that is going to be a big, big challenge. So that might actually be a little bit too much. There's another oil spot over there, but on another really big enemy base. Small one over there, that could be worthwhile, maybe. We only have one oil spot over there. That's not worth our trouble for now. I think this will be our next expansion for sure. Then we can have a train going up along this way. It can be unloaded in this area somewhere. And then oil can be brought up along here in towards our main oil reserve, I think. Anyway, that's it for this episode. So please leave a like and a comment below if you enjoyed this content and want to see more. And I'll see you guys for whatever video I do next.